We shall now summarize all what we have done till now with the help of a project, a simple project rather. The whole objective being to clarify the concepts. We are not editing any sort as any CSS or any colors. You can add them yourself. It is matter of about adding them to the layout. We are not going to add all those CSS and all, just keeping the thing simple. We will try to display it like this. We'll first of all display a table of animals, like name of the animal and a details button, a delete, so that here it appears like cheetah, the name of the animal, and then detail this link or a delete one, so that when the user clicks on the detail, then he is taken to the new page, and on that page he is able to read the details of this animal and come back. So it's basically about navigation. And when he clicks the delete button, the animal should vanish from the database. So this is what we start with. We'll add a couple of more things to it also as we go. So let us see how do we do this one with MVC. To begin with, we have already created some of the things here. First of all, an empty home controller with an index method. We haven't yet added the index view, an entity models folder plus database. In the database, we have created a TBL animals having two columns, animal code and animal name. And we also have added some data to it so that we save time. Animal code is in chimpanzee, lion, followed by the names. Apart from this, coming back to the Solution Explorer, we have also added certain content also. It's my personal recommendation that put all your content inside content folder. It will keep your Solution Explorer very neat. So I have created a folder called website. Of course, you could have given a better name. Themes is already there, site.css is already there, and if you want to put any colors, you can make use of the site.css, edit it according to your will, or optionally add more CSS files to the content folder. And let me now go to the website. What does it contain? Inside it, we have pasted images as per the animal code. Oh, it was a mistake actually. As per the animal code. So if we look at here, cheetah corresponds to this, chimpanzee corresponds to this. Now, it's my personal view that these pictures should not be added to the database. Keep your database light. Keep your database light. Content should always be put inside folders. You will find that maintenance is far, far easier. All big websites, they make use of direct backend FTP. There are seldom any changes to the code. Some frontend code might be written for adding new animals to this. You can of course add in the coming lectures. Adding just to records or deleting. But most of the content will reside in the file system. And file system has to be named very correctly. Cheetah.html. This contains the description of cheetah, chimpanzee. In this page, this is a text file with the HTML extension, We haven't added any doc type and all story. This will ensure that your website is very easy to maintain. To add one animal, you have to just go to the front end, add a code for the animal and add a name for the animal. And for the remaining part, a backend employee can upload the image with the same ID and a description consisting of complete HTML can be uploaded. For instance, this one. This is containing HTML tags freely. You can paste any YouTube link, embed any YouTube link. It will all work correctly. I've opened the YouTube and a gorilla. I'll just copy the embed code, copy, come back to my website. Here I'll write H2 video and paste that. I haven't changed anything, brought it fully inside here, and you will see that the maintenance of the website is very easy. We have added it to Chimpanzee, and so in summary, I would like to tell you that keep your database as small, as light as possible, because even if you go very with a lot of keeping the things very small, even when you observe so much of care to keep the database size small, even then databases, they tend to become very big. You should put all data into database only that is absolutely required, otherwise maintain it inside the file system. Why would I say this one? This is your C# code. This is your database. Any query that goes to database goes through the process of marshalling from C# to C code. A lot many layers pass. But if you can write merely some code in the file system, then a simple C# query to the file system can make it faster. Okay, things apart. So we have put a description folder consisting of HTML and images. So we have to actually now design a website so that we are able to display the animals and also demonstrate the concepts of the MVC that we have learned so far. So as our first step, let us add our entity models. Add new item, ADO.NET entity model. ADO.NET entity model. I'll give it name mmod zoo and click add. Generate from database, yes. Just click next. Tick mark it off. Finish. This is what gets added for you. And from here on, we'll begin to work on our controllers. From here, we'll start in our next lecture.